We are less than an hour away from the start of the Iowa caucuses, where residents of the Hawkeye State will cast the first votes of the 2024 presidential race.
But will the coldest caucus day on record keep voters away? Chief political reporter John Croman is live for us in Des Moines tonight.
That is the question, whether the weather will affect all the candidates equally or hurt some more than others. It's something that the pundits have been talking about here, speculating about here in Iowa. Dave is swinging over to get a shot of the registration table where Republicans are arriving and checking in for this event. And it have to be here at 7 p.m. to take part in that caucus, which consists of people listening to speeches and then voting in a secret ballot straw poll. Now, some Iowans are still digging out from the storm where the snowfall was far heavier than it was up in Minnesota. Some counties, there's only one or two caucus sites. People will need to get to their site on really snow-packed roads. And, you know, Ted Cruz won here in 2016, but 8 years later, it is solid Trump territory, especially outside the Des Moines metro. But Nikki Haley's supporters say that they feel she's making some inroads here.
We're just really excited about all of the enthusiasm that we see for Nikki. Really, the caucus early state game is about momentum. And so making sure that you have a ticket to get out of Iowa to New Hampshire.
You know what? I'm here to support President Trump because he has a proven track record of leadership. And I buy gas and groceries just like everybody else. And things have skyrocketed. The inflation is out of control.
That was Congressman Derek Van Orden, who represents much of western Wisconsin. He's one of many GOP members of Congress who've come down here to Iowa to make sure that the former president wins here and by a large margin. As I said, a place called North High School in Des Moines. It's a joint caucus site for both Republicans and Democrats. Republicans will be doing a straw poll. Democrats aren't doing their presidential primary presidential preference poll tonight. They're putting that off, but they're doing it by mail and not releasing the results until after the South Carolina primary, which is the DNC's chosen first contest in the nation. So we'll see how this shakes out. Should be pretty interesting to watch going forward.
All right, John, we'll see you tonight.